One, two, three.
Fuck it.
Lumix, why the jingle jangle? You know people are gonna primarily be using your camera as a video camera. You know how noisy the jingle jangle is. Why not go with the fixed loop? See this? That's the fixed loop. It's much stronger, confidence inspiring, no noise. Sony is also guilty of the jingle jangle. You see, I've got some tape over it, but this thing, why? Doesn't make any sense. Better, but I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with my camera strap now. But they look terrible. Better. This camera here doesn't have like a flip out so I have to plug in an external monitor, but there was a minor mishap last week. I yanked the camera and it was still connected to this thing, and this thing just, well, it broke. It broke into like a million pieces. And one of the bits that I couldn't figure out how to properly fix was the part that connected to like the tripod mount. So my fix here is just to permanently attach it to this little Gorilla Pod and try hot glue. Totally works.
Don't seem to care, but my love is real. Lonely is the night, wanting him to hold me.
Dear Canon, quick question. What were you possibly thinking when you thought it was a good idea to put this little button right here? Let me explain. This is the Canon G7X, widely regarded as the best point and shoot for vlogging on the market. I agree that it's the best point and shoot for vlogging on the market. But why? Why does it have this stupid button right here? It's really a super huge big deal because when you use this camera, you use this flip up monitor right here so you can see yourself, so you vlog like this. Now, when the monitor is flipped up, you can't hold it from the sides, there's no way. You can't hold it from the top because the monitor's in the way. The only way to hold it is like this. Your thumb lands there and your other finger lands right here, directly over this button. Finger, button, finger, button, finger, button. I'm holding it like this. I'm recording, this happens to me all the time. I accidentally push the stupid button and what happens? It cancels my recording, stops recording, and asks me to enter a nickname for this camera. Who gives a camera a nickname? I give my dog a nickname. I don't need to interrupt a shoot to give my camera a nickname. Now, to simply bitch about a product, that's just complaining. I prefer to offer solutions because that's constructive.
He don't seem to care.
And there we go. The piece of the CD covers the button, so no matter how much I squeeze, it will never activate it again. Tape holds it in place.
I don't know if you remember this thing or not. It's one of my favorite toys.
I accidentally dropped it out of the back of my car, and then I left it outside overnight, two nights in a row, and then I rode it in the ocean. It still works, but it kind of acts a little bit funny. I described this to the company, and they were like, "Do you think we know what the problem is?" So they sent me a new foot pad sensor. You know, one of the things that Candace says that she really likes about me is how tough my hands are. You can never really trust a man that has really smooth, soft hands. To fix this thing, you have to unscrew 8 Allen head screws, and rather than turning this Allen wrench like 1,000 times, I'm just gonna chop it in half so I can put it in my power driver. Now I don't have to turn it by hand. Back to the product review. So if there's one problem with this thing, it's that you can't get up curves. And the reason why that's lame is because the biggest concern is this thing with the step. Right now I need to go up the curb. There's just no way. And this leads me into the next chapter, which I can't remember what I wrote down, but is about improvement and how this thing could be made better. I think I have an idea as to how to make this hoverboard thing so it actually, I can get up a step, I can get up a curb. I'm gonna do that now. That's that. Problem solved. I'm taking down the Facebook painting today. I'm not getting rid of it, I'm just moving it. It's hard to ollie a longboard. This is one of those situations where I wish I had one or two or three or four people to help me. But I don't. Ah! Oh God, it's so heavy. Ah, it's so heavy. Now, this couch positioning, it's not permanent. I don't know where it's gonna go. I don't know if I'm gonna keep this couch, but I know that I want like a living room like atmosphere in this part of the studio. So I'm gonna put it there as like a placeholder to build the rest of the space out around it. Well, it does kind of fit in here nicely. I have a slight feng shui concern, which is walking in the front door and seeing the couch. mixed emotions there. See what I mean? Now, I'm not much of a drinker. I also don't think the kind of work that I do in here dovetails very well with booze at all. And I really don't believe in imposing my beliefs on other people, so I think it's important to have a full bar to offer people who come by the studio. I've got all this booze here, I just need to install a shelf and some sort of something. I think it'll tie that whole area together very nicely. Mirror looks good, gives a little depth to the space. I really wanted to get the speakers hung tonight and then the shelf that go above the speakers and then get the speakers wired and have this whole... Truth is, last night on date night, I got a little bit of food poisoning or just something awful and I've been like pretty beat up all day. So I'm just gonna end the vlog right here. Full speed! Full speed back to the office. It's about to get bad. All right, I love a good storm. I don't want to miss this one. I'm going to be more prepared. I'm putting on some foul weather gear. I got some pink flip-flops. All right, I'm going out, switching over to go, wait. Nothing's getting through this. A pretty serious rainstorm, but they said a hail. I didn't see any hail. Candace offered to come pick me up. Hope that offer still stands. Definitely not boosted board weather. This is sort of an impromptu mail time. I'd like to say thank you to Redkin for sending me this towel. I would also like to thank Communique for sending me this sweet sweatshirt. Without your generous mail time packages, I would be both wet and cold right now. Okay, gotta get out of here. Gotta get out of here. Okay. Leaving the office. Slightly damp. Excuse me.
Some food, I guess.
Holy smokes. It's raining out, huh?
Yeah.
That was scary.
Lightning? You're scared of lightning?
It's always more fun to feature the new construction, like the new red wall, and my new desk, and my second new desk. What's a lot less sexy to talk about is the deconstruction that's happening. For example, back in my former office here, this whole wall, which used to be beautiful and had the speakers up here, decimated. In fact, this entire office has just been like, destroyed. This office is going to be the apex of the new studio design. So it's going to be the most destroyed, the most broken down before it gets built back up. Right now we're attacking the easy things. The desk, the wall should be done very soon. This area here all should be done soon. The very last thing we're going to tackle, the last thing we're going to take on, the room in the back. This is an opaque projector. You take an image, the image inside here, it's supposed to project that image on whatever's in front of it. But it's not strong enough, it doesn't work. Okay, yeah. Multimedia projector, this should work. I shouldn't want to have to move it. Feel pretty good about this. Gonna do a nice molding by the play button here, but I need the wood to be black underneath it. So I'm cheating it with just a little bit of paint. That is nice. Nice. I wanted the Dr. Dre headphones, but they sounded terrible, so I got these instead. I only wanted the Beats because I liked the way they looked, and they're endorsed by the second coolest living rapper. The Bose sounded better, but there's nothing interesting about the way they look or their endorsement by this white guy and American Airlines.
Thank you.
Thanks. Take care. Spray paint doesn't bond well with glossy plastics, so I hit the headphones with 220 weight sandpaper. Masking requires precision. I am not a precise person. A quarter served as the perfect template for the new logo. Most people spray paint incorrectly. Patience is the key. Short bursts, 8 to 10 inches from the target, 10 minutes between coats. Printed the logo off the Beats website and made 2 stencils. A little spray mount kept them in place. Bingo. So I got my new laptop yesterday. Pretty excited about it. Thought I would spend like a half a minute talking about this thing today. Okay, so in yesterday's vlog, I said it came from China, which it did, because I had a custom build done. Yes, I did get a little excited with the unboxing and did a tiny little scratch. Really no big deal. The next thing I like to do with my new computers is customize them, make them mine, by writing my name on them. Now, to write my name in pencil or pen would be too impermanent, so I use this. This is a Neistat brand engraver. I'm gonna switch over to this big camera here so the image will be a little bit more clean for these close-ups. I think it came out pretty good. The single biggest problem with not having a front-facing screen is when you think you're shooting with a super wide angle, but it's actually zoomed all the way in and you're just getting a close-up shot of your nose. I don't need a zoom lens to see this nose. Now with Canon, that's not a big deal. I would have, and then I could see that it was all the way in. And then I could just see. I could correct the fact that it was zoomed all the way in. I've been struggling to come up with a solution. I'm not gonna put an external screen on this. Like, I need to be able to throw this thing around. I think I figured out how to do it. And this white pen contains the solution. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Now, at a glance, you know, if these white stripes are lined up here, then it's as wide as it'll go. If you look at the camera and it's like that, you're like, oh shit, it's zoomed in. Bam, like that, and it's as wide as it'll go, and you never need to check. I hope that makes sense. I know it's wide right now because these white stripes are lined up. I know it's tight right now because the white stripes are not lined up. It's all about the white stripes. There she is. The drone is still there. The drone is still on the rooftop. I can see it just behind me. I can also see there's no way I'm getting on that roof. It's all residential buildings. They're all highly secure. I can't go to an adjacent building and climb over. There's no access. I need an entirely new approach. Quite a few things that could go wrong in this scenario, but the one that I'm most worried about is after I hook it and I'm pulling it up the 300 feet, if and when it falls, that's good night. That is lights out, that's doom. All right, let's see how this goes. Come on. Mission accomplished. Woo-wee! This is what I'm excited about. A brand spanking new boosted board. There aren't that many products or companies that I so openly endorse, Boosted Board is a company that I highly endorse with no hesitations. The CEO saw on my YouTube channel that I had totaled both of mine, so he asked me to send him mine back, and in return, he sent me this brand new Boosted Board. Now, that's just an awesome thing to do, and that's why I don't hesitate at all to talk about Boosted Board or feature them so much in my vlog. They also... They also just know how to take care of their customers. So few companies have both a great product and take care of their customers. I cannot tell you how happy I am to have a little Boosted Board action back in my life. I cannot begin to tell you how psyched I am to get out there and rage on this thing. I love a heat wave like nothing else, and I wish we had more. Hey Casey, I love your vlog. I wanted to send you some artwork to show my appreciation for the amazing content you have. Thanks, Ray, Squishy Puss. Dear Ray, thank you for sending me this here squishy. Squishy Puss. I will make sure Squishy Puss has a nice home in my office. While I'm building stuff, do you want to see another recent upgrade to the studio that I'm particularly proud of? So this is the table that I sit at here. I sit there, but right next to the table here, I have all these little hop-ups. Say I'm hot, like right now I'm very hot, and I need to turn on the air conditioner. AC's on. Maybe I need to plug in my cell phone or anything that's a USB into my stupid computer that only takes this stupid thing, so I have to use this stupid dongle. Here's the dongle. And say I want to turn on my stereo. And I don't want to get up. Here's the remote. All right. Now, without a doubt, the hardest part of me having been away for the last couple weeks was being away from my family. But in a very, very close second place. For the hardest thing about being away for the last couple weeks was knowing that these two guys right here were sitting in the office. Now, a few months ago, you might remember, I had a very early boosted board version 2 prototype here in the studio. That was not a working, like, fully functional prototype. That was just me like harassing boosted, being like, send me anything, I just want to check it out. And they were super cool, and they sent me, that is crazy bright, and they sent me that one with a disclaimer that, like, Casey, this is not a finished product. Okay, this is a finished product. Boosted. I have been waiting so long for this, and I was especially heartbroken after losing my boosted board in Colorado. Does that look better? I can't ever tell. Overexposed. And man, oh man, would I love to have had one of these bastards while I was while I was in South America. Wow. Oh, boosted me likey. Boosted board version 2. And as a boosted board veteran, there's one thing I know, and that is that the only thing better than a brand new version 2 boosted board is two brand new version 2 boosted boards. Did I really need two of these things? Probably not. Did I get overexcited and get two of these? Yeah. Any regrets? None whatsoever. Hey, boosted, what does loaded mean? All right, boosted five, ready to be christened. Very, very minor change of plans. I'm actually gonna take the unmarked boosted six here instead of boosted five because the paint doesn't seem to wanna dry and I like got all over my clothes and my hands. I'm just gonna take the new one that I haven't even put an arrow on yet. Casey, when are you going to make another pair? How about right now? Making these things, it's not that hard. I don't know how many pair I've made over the years. The truth is, I don't lose them and they don't really break, but they do expire. It's like all the bounce that's in the plastic that makes up the frame, it just starts to stretch out in time. Right now I'm scraping the logo off of the lens. See? Plus, I have a tendency to lose things and I'm making these so I've got a fresh pair and then this old pair here will become my backup pair. Just taking down the logo there, get a little paint in it. The last step here is just hitting them with the paint. You break every rule of spray painting because what you want is you want it to sink into the cracks, see? You just flood them with paint. That is the sloppiest, worst spray paint job you'll ever see me do. Now I'll just leave them there to sit overnight. When I wake up in the morning, I'll scrape the paint off and they'll look kind of like these, probably with just a touch more paint. Now, the biggest question that I get asked is why? Why do I always wear sunglasses? The first part of the answer is I just like the way glasses look. There's a really pragmatic reason. Okay, you know how when I'm talking to camera, like I'm talking to camera right now, I can always point at things like, hey, look at this screen right here, or check out these lights behind me, or check out this blue lunchbox right here, or this movie poster from the movie I produced right there. The Godfather, it's right here. I'm not looking into the lens, I'm looking into this screen right here. And that way I can frame things up, I know what I'm looking at, but when I do with my glasses off, I don't look like I'm looking at you. I look over here. So like, imagine if in all my vlogs, I'm looking like this, it starts to feel really weird. And I can look back here and then look over there, try to pretend to look over there. But in the end, it's just like, if I want to point at this, I can either look over here, or I have to look here and just sort of guess. But when I have glasses on, it always looks like I'm looking at camera. So that's why I started wearing glasses in all my vlogs. It's like a really practical reason. That's why I always have them on at night. It's just like, it's the only way I can check my framing without having it look weird. I always think when people vlog and they're not looking into the lens, it's like, it doesn't. What about my glasses?
What about your glasses? They're awesome.
That's, you're lying.
No, I'm not.
How come you always yell at me when I put them on then?
Because your eyes are so cute and pretty and then you cover them with these glasses.
I don't know what you're talking about.
But you have such pretty brown eyes.
I think I went maybe a little overboard with the balloons.
Works, I guess.
Okay, I'm in my apartment building. I'm gonna get the bicycle first. No one stole it. I'm gonna
dress the flowers out here. All right, all that remains now are the balloons. Okay, it's 6 a.m. now. Balloons are in place, bike is in place, drawing is in place, flowers are in place. Everyone's still asleep and the dog hasn't barked. I think the baby's up. Francie, I need you to help me with one last present for mommy, okay? Will you help me? You did a nice job. You need a nice painting for mommy.
Oh my God, Casey, you always go so crazy.